The officer-involved shooting that put Martavious Banks in the hospital has sparked a number of protests and conversations across Shelby County and West Tennessee.
Now, this has raised the question of whether the Tennessee Bureau of Investigation should be investigating every officer-involved shooting. Now, later today, the Shelby County Commission plans on discussing this very topic. Van Turner serves as the Shelby County Commission chairman.
Good to have you.
Mr. Turner, always glad to have you back here. We know the committee approved this measure recently. Now it goes to the full county commission. What's your stance on it? What should be done?
Well, I'm supportive. Of course, we want to make sure that these kinds of incidents are investigated properly. And I think that it's something that's supported by both law enforcement agencies, both the Shelby County Sheriff's Office and the Memphis Police Department. We just want to make sure the language is tweaked and everything is ready to go. And I think it's going to come down to a funding issue, and that's why it'll have to have concurrent legislation at the state level.
What do you mean? What where is the funding involved? Just for TBI to, we have to pay for that? Or?
Well, yeah, the manpower that they would have to
So Shelby
for.
County would have to reimburse?
Well, I don't think so. I think the state would just come in and do it.
Okay.
There's been no talk of reimbursements.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
However, it is a situation where, you know, you're putting more added responsibility on the state, and so they have to make sure that they can fiscally be able to do these kinds of investigations.
Right. Gotcha. Take us behind the scenes, though. What prompted this? Is this part of a kind of a follow-through with what happened to Mr. Martavious Banks and that police shooting, or is this all of the above, or what?
Yeah, I think so. And, you know, fortunately, we don't see these kinds of incidents often. And so I want to be the first to say I appreciate the fine job that our sheriff's office is doing, as well as the Memphis Police Department. This is not anything that's against those departments. We just want to make sure that they're protected and individuals in the community are protected. So a neutral entity coming in to investigate these kinds of incidents protects both the law enforcement agency and the affected individuals.
Kind of an objective eye. Now,
correct.
As we look at this, have we looked at whether other Tennessee cities have looked at doing the same thing, have ever asked for the same thing? I mean, would that be a factor in whether the TBI wants to do this?
Well, perhaps so. And my understanding is that this is now an MOU, so it's an agreement between Shelby County and Memphis Police Department.
MOU is?
An MOU is a memorandum of understanding,
okay,
which allows them, or a memorandum of agreement that we have here for Shelby County and the city of Memphis, which allows the TBI to come in if there is a homicide. So this resolution is just asking that that agreement be tweaked and say that there is, if there are significant injuries, that they also would come in. And again, we have to make sure that they're able to do so via their budgetary concerns and their budgetary restraints. And so that's why there's sort of co-legislation happening at the state level as well.
Gotcha.
So your gut feeling again, Commissioner, is that this will likely pass, or you're pretty optimistic?
Yeah, I think so. And it's a joint resolution to be passed by both the city of Memphis as well as Shelby County. Okay. Again, we're going to look at the language very closely this afternoon and make sure that we have good language and that it's something that will pass muster.
Have you done some intel on the state level? Have you heard from legislators who are either, yeah, we could do this or not? Because, you know, as you know so well, Memphis has not always had the easiest relationship with the state legislature.
Well, there's bipartisan legislation pending now, and so we're hopeful that it makes it out of committee. Of course, we won't know until January.
Right.
But we're optimistic that this is something that the state would want as well. And we're optimistic that this is something that they will want to apply statewide.
Another issue that's really come up over the past few days, unfortunately involving the tragic murder of Phil Chenery, the head of the Memphis Chamber of Commerce, and whether or not perhaps the county should get involved in the search for his replacement, his successor. Where do you stand there? I know Shelby County Mayor Lee Harris seems to be pushing in that direction. Should the county play a role in it, not just the chamber, or who?
You know, I think that's a chamber issue. I respect what the mayor has stated, and I think that, you know, governments can be involved in other ways. I think that, you know, they probably would come to us and ask us what's our opinion and ask for our input in an informal way. I don't know if a formal search committee would be formed. My thought now is that they would probably put someone in as an interim, mm-hmm. and then they may, you know, form a national search committee. And as part of that search team's efforts to locate someone, they will come speak to county government. Right. They will go speak to city government. Sure. So I think that it will happen anyway.
And what type of person do you? Relationship,
yeah. But, what type of person do you think though is needed? Because we've heard so much, especially in recent days, recent weeks, that Phil Gennari, you know, really led that economic charge, representing the city and the county, and was a big part of that economic engine. Who needs to? What type of person needs to head this agency?
Well, I mean, it'd have to be someone like Phil. I mean, he definitely was someone that pushed economic development. He pushed diversity. He pushed innovation. And I think that we would want an individual just like Mr. Trinari. We're going to miss him, but I think that in his legacy, we should put someone in that position who would do the same job and keep that same philosophy of inclusion, of making Memphis a progressive city, and of making Memphis a better city.
Big shoes to fill, no doubt.
Yes.
Thank you so much for your time and your service.
Thank you
so
much.
Always glad to see you.
Thank you.
All right.